So today we're going to talk about cupping. Cupping has been used for thousands of years. It's used by different cultures all over the world. And it's simply placing a cup over the skin and providing negative pressure inside of the cup. This is achieved through fire cupping, as I'm sure you've seen on the movies. Basically, you add a flame to it, eats up the oxygen, you put it on the skin and it sucks it up. You can use silicone cups that are really gentle that you just press and provide that negative pressure, or you can use plastic cups and a hand pump to suck out the air. They're used for pain, so injuries that you've had, specifically over large muscle groups. By providing that over the area, it expands the tissue and allows a lot of the metabolic waste to come to the surface so that the skin can kind of get rid of it and clean it out. And during that process, it's also bringing up fresh blood, which holds oxygen and different immune properties to help heal the area, oxygenate the area, and kind of speed up the recovery. So that said, it is also used with a lot of people who work out a lot. So you're finding now a lot of professional athletes are going to cupping because, again, they're able to recuperate faster and move on to their next exercise. It can be used for things like asthma. So for instance, that negative pressure placed over the lung tissue helps it expand. So you normally have inflammation in there, and that causes a lot of phlegm, mucus buildup, which causes it to be harder to cough up or to just breathe in general. The negative pressure opens that up, expands it, and allows the person to get some of that stuff out so that they can move on. Some people use it for scar tissue. So we're speaking scar tissue that's on the skin and also scar tissue that's under the skin from previous surgeries. And what that does is the negative pressure helps that scar tissue in the fascia or in the muscle expand. And by expanding it, it gives it a little bit of flexibility and allows a little bit more healing process to go on into that area. We can use it for different inflammation, joint issues, because again, it just allowing that circulation in the area really speeds things up, because when we're tense, when we have a lot of inflammation in an area, the circulation automatically goes down. The cupping is a physical way to force all them materials to move around in there and allow the body to heal itself. It's used for colds and flus. A lot of times it's used over the lungs to stimulate the immune function and to kind of help the cold find its way out of the body. I've read a lot of people in Latin America use that as a very, very old therapy whenever they seen that that young people had colds and flus. That was one of their first go-to treatments. And the reason why people do it is, again, to get rid of toxins, to get better range of motion, to decrease pain in a specific area, to increase the body's response to healing, again, for working out, for pain. There's different forms of cupping. We have a sliding cupping where we place some lotion or some oil on the skin and actually move the cups around. It could tend to be very stimulating, so some people don't like it, but again, it speeds things up, helps things move. Some people like a deeper massage, some people like a lighter massage, so it's just basically a different level of stimulation that you get out of this. We have the stationary cupping, where we place directly over a trigger point to really get into that area and help things move around. You have your silicone cups, which are really, really light and thin. A lot of people are going to use those on the face, bringing more chi and blood to the skin, to the muscles, to the collagen, to kind of help pick the face up, make it look a little bit more brighter. We have people that will use cupping for cellulite. Now, it does not get rid of cellulite, but the negative pressure causes that cellulite to kind of smooth out a little bit, so it's not as noticeable when you look at it. Bites. So you got bug bites, ant bites, fire ant bites. Placing a cup over it, you can literally see the poison, if it's done immediately, come out. Some people have used it for small abscesses on the body. By gently cupping the area, it causes whatever fluids are in that abscess to slowly leak out. To just make sure you're getting kind of everything out without having to squeeze it, which is going to be a lot more painful. So the negative pressure will allow that to just kind of gently come to the surface. Some people look at it and it does kind of look painful when you see the marks left afterwards. Those marks are similar to a bruise, but they're not a bruise. Usually on your first cupping session, you will tend to be a little bit sore in the evening because that's the first time your body ever experienced that sensation. After that, you're usually not sore, and usually by the night, the end of the day, you actually feel a lot better because the body was able to go in there and use the immune system to help heal whatever aches and pains you were having. But again, the mark does stay there for 3 to 7 days, depending on how stagnant it is, how hydrated you are, how active you are, but those usually kind of just go away all by themselves.